Well, good morning and praise the Lord. You guys are probably wondering where I've been. Well, I just want to let you know that God has been good. I had some heart surgery, but I'm back again. And so I just want to say thank you to all the saints of God who've been praying for me. I'm a month removed, and so I'm healing. And so God is just good. I can't say anymore. So I want to say welcome this morning. This is the very first Sunday of July 2018, and so we have a treat today. I've invited two people. I'm not sure which one's going to show up, but whichever one shows up, we want you to grab your plate today, pull up to the table and eat. And so I'm so thankful for the minister who has carried on during my absence. I haven't been able to get out and do those things that I like to do. But God said that my grace is sufficient for thee, and so that's where I've been. I've been riding on the grace of God. And so now today, I want you to just be attentive to the Word of God, because after all is said and done, it's the Word of God that's going to keep us. It is the very Word of God that's going to carry us home to glory. And so I want you to sit back, don't relax. Get ready to enjoy the Word of God. Now I want to introduce to some of you Evangelist Dorette Moxon. Praise God. A mighty woman of God. She don't like me to do that. But you know what? She is a mighty woman of God.
Yes. Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
I know she has a word for us today. You know, because she's a Holy Ghost filled mighty woman of
yeah.
God.
Thank
Amen.
You, Jesus.
And so Hallelujah. I'm so grateful to the Lord because he sent her to us at a time when we really needed a boost. And that, so he sent her to us, and it's just been hallelujah and amen. So y'all put your hands together for Evangelist Dorette Moxon.
Hallelujah.
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 Glory. Praise the Lord, somebody.
Hallelujah.
Give your praise
yes,
in
Lord.
The sanctuary this morning.
Jesus.
You said, if I be lifted up,
draw somebody this morning.
Yes, Lord.
Draw a family member this morning.
Yes, Lord.
Draw a friend this morning.
Yeah.
Draw someone in the hospital this morning.
Yes,
draw someone in the prison this morning.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Draw someone on the streets this morning.
Hallelujah.
God, somebody's in trouble.
Yeah.
Trouble at every end.
Yes,
but God, you can still bless.
Yeah.
You can still save. Oh God, draw this morning. God, I pray that you touch me this morning. Crucify self this morning. Put self under subjection this morning. Let your word, God, be glorified. Let your name be glorified, Lord. Let your people, God, be electrified with your word this morning. Break out a revival in this place this morning. God, let the spirit of the Holy Ghost fall afresh this morning. Sweet Holy Spirit, sweet heavenly dove, stay right here with us, Lord, and fill us with your love. Oh God, let the power of the Holy Ghost flow through like a mighty rushing wind this morning. Fill this place with your presence. Fill this place with your presence. Let every other power be subjected to the highest power, which is Christ Jesus. Bind every force on every end. Dismantle every plan of the enemy this morning. Cancel every plan of the enemy, God, in the name of Jesus. And speak, Lord, speak this morning. Speak, Lord, speak this morning. We need a word, God, from heaven.
Hallelujah.
Let heaven be open and God release your word this morning.
Yeah.
There is no mention mention that anything died and rose on the third day. There is no mention that anything died and rose from the dead. But there is one. Glory be to God. His name is Jesus. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Somebody ought to give him glory.
Hallelujah.
Praise his name.
Glory.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Thank you, Jesus.
I thank God for this another day that the Lord hath made.
Yes.
And I will rejoice and be glad in it. Yes. Hallelujah. I've asked the Lord to give me a word. Hallelujah. And the Lord began to minister to me. Don't you know when God is giving you a word for the people, he preached to you before you preached to them.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Glory be to God. And so the Holy Ghost began to preach to me, and God was giving me the word. And I received it. I said, Lord, I received it. I'm receiving it. Touch the ear of the people to be receptive. Touch the heart to receive the word. For when the word comes, and it comes from God, something different is going to happen. It's the super connecting to the natural.
Well,
so something supernatural must happen.
Hallelujah.
Glory be to God.
Thank you.
For the word is power. Hallelujah.
Glory.
And today we cannot live without the word of God.
Hallelujah.
I don't care what kind of solution they give to your problem. The solution is in the word of God.
Yes.
Everything that you need is in the word of God.
Yes.
Glory be to God.
Glory.
Every remedy that you need is in the word of God.
Hallelujah.
Every answer to your problem is in the word of God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Every time you're feeling like you're weak, connect with the word, because the word will make you stronger. Glory be to God. Don't you know if you open your Bible and read the word in a time of crisis, God will change everything. Glory be to God.
Hallelujah.
And your crisis will turn to Christ His.
Yes.
Glory be to God. For if Christ is in the vessel, you have to smile at all your storms.
Yeah.
Glory be to God. I thank God this morning.
Amen.
Hallelujah. We just read from the book of Isaiah. And I want to tell you a little about this prophet. He's known as one of the major prophets. But indeed, everyone believes that he is the most important prophet that was ever mentioned in the Bible. Hallelujah. And that's because he lived to serve so many kings. Glory be to God. That he was doing a work for God that was so many years of his service to God. Isaiah was a prophet that would speak to the people. He would speak to them about God and what God required of them.
Uh-huh.
And we know that the children of Israel was a disobedient bunch.
Yeah.
They did everything that God said not to do.
Yes.
They worshiped idols. They did everything that was outside of the laws of God. Hallelujah. But God gave them a king that ruled with an iron fist. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory be to God. So three times the Babylonians took the children of Israel into captivity.
Well,
God allowed it to happen because they would not abide by what God wanted them to do.
Yeah.
So when you feel like you want to do your own thing, remember that God has consequences for those who choose to disobey him.
Yes.
Glory be to God. Obedience is better than sacrifice. So we know that if we obey God, God is going to do what he say he will do.
Yeah.
You have the right to call on him in the time of trouble if you obey God.
Hallelujah.
Knowing that your faith will just be ignited and connect with God in heaven.
Yes.
And when you connect with God in heaven, God will open the windows of heaven and he will restore It's one thing to be in church, but the best thing to be is the church.
Amen.
You see, the church building won't keep us.
Amen.
The church building won't save us. Glory be to God. But let me tell you this morning that if you present your body as a living sacrifice,
hallelujah,
holy and acceptable unto God,
yes,
glory be to God. The scripture said that's your reasonable service.
Yes.
God is only asking you to be holy,
yes,
to live holy.
Yes.
For God, He is holy.
Yes.
Glory be to God. Holiness is God's standard of living,
yes,
for His people.
Yes, Lord. Yes.
Without holiness, no man can see God.
Yes.
Glory be to God. Without holiness, no man can see God.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Somebody ought to get new.
Yes.
Give Him praise.
Hallelujah.
Lift Him up this morning.
Yes.
Hallelujah. So as we read in the scripture, we realize that throughout the Old Testament, that the eagle represented God. Hallelujah. For the eagle had attributes of God.
Yes.
Hallelujah. There is something about the eagle that makes it a different kind of bird.
All right.
A unique bird.
Ah.
The eagle really don't mingle with the ordinary birds.
Come on now.
Hallelujah. The only time you see the eagle with the other birds is when he comes to get something to eat. And he's going to come in and eat and he's going to leave. He's not going to stay and mingle with the other birds. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Sometimes we want to act like the pigeons. Hallelujah. Just mumble and grumble all day. Glory be to God. Every time you see a pigeon, he's mumbling, ooh, all the time. Glory be to God. But the eagle is set on altitude.
Amen.
The eagle wants to go higher and higher and higher. Glory be to
God.
So we see where God, hallelujah, reminds us of the eagle. The eagle likes to take the little eaglets, the little young ones, take them in the atmosphere, up in the air,
well,
to teach them how to fly.
Yeah.
Glory be to God. And the eagle will let go of the baby eagle and help it to learn how to fly.
Uh-huh.
So when the baby eagle seems like it's going to fall, the eagle goes back and catch it up. Glory be to God. Then it goes higher and further up in the air. And then it lets it go again. And then the eaglet starts to learn how to fly.
Well,
and it seems like he's going to drop again. Then the eagle goes back and catches the little young one. Glory be to God. But after a while, hallelujah, the eaglet begin to know how to fly on its own.
Well,
hallelujah. Don't you know God is so gracious to us,
yes,
that He won't even just put us out there to be eaten by different prey.
Yes.
Glory be to God.
Yes.
He will teach us how to fly.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Yes. Glory be to God. And if we feel like we're falling sometimes, God, He will uphold us,
yes,
with His right hand,
yes,
of righteousness.
Yes. Yes.
Glory be to God.
Mm-hmm. Yes,
and it feels like you're struggling out to fly.
Well,
God said, I will hold you, yes, in the palm of my hand.
Hey, hey.
Glory be to God.
Yes.
Hallelujah, somebody. And when we go through that struggle one more time and we think it's over, just know that it ain't over until God says it's,
hey,
over.
Hey, hey.
Glory be to God, for God will give you some wings to fly with in your time of troubles.
Yes.
He will give you wings in the time when you struggle.
Yes.
Glory be to God. But the scripture said, but they that wait upon the Lord.
All right.
Glory be to God. There is a time when you just have to wait for God to move.
Yes.
And when God say move, that's when you move.
Yes.
But when you move on your own, you'll be like that eagle who is not watching what the mother is doing and will fall flat and die.
Yes.
Glory be to God. But God will uphold us.
Yes, Lord.
Yes.
If we lean on Him.
Hey. Yes.
Glory be to God. There are several attributes of an eagle. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. You realize that the eagle have eyes, vision eyes. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. See far ahead. See when the enemy is coming. Hallelujah. He can look ahead and stay away from the danger. Mm-hmm. Glory be to God. So when we fix our eyes on Jesus, hallelujah, keep your eyes centered on Him. He will lead you. He will guide you. He will show you where to go. Glory be to God. He will keep you from the hands of the enemies. Hallelujah. Somebody said, I'm sitting in the position with a 270-degree neck. Like the owl. You know, the owl can turn his neck 270 degrees. Glory be to God. So when the enemy is coming in like a flood, hallelujah, your vision eyes will see the enemy. The owl will go boop, boop, all the way around. Glory be to God. Hallelujah, somebody.
Hallelujah.
So God will give us, glory be to God, eyes with vision to see when the enemy is coming.
Yes.
Glory be to God.
Thank you.
And we know that if God is with us, then who can be against us?
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory be to God. There are wings that God will give us in our time of struggle.
Yes.
We struggle because we do not stand on the promises of God. We don't stand on God's promise. He said, I will never forsake you. I will never leave you or forsake you.
Yes.
Even when your mother and your father give you up, I will keep you.
Yes, yes, yes.
Glory be to God. He said, I will give my angel charge over you to keep you in all your ways.
Yes.
Glory be to God. So when you're going through your struggles, know that when you're going through, if God is with you, you are victorious.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Stand on the word of God. For when you call on Jesus, He's going to answer. David said, in the time of trouble, He will hide me in His pavilion.
Uh-huh.
In the secret of His tabernacle shall He hide me. Glory be to God. Let God be your fortress this morning.
Yeah.
He is a refuge and strength in the time of trouble.
Yeah.
For in the time of trouble, He will keep you.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. He's that bridge over troubled waters.
Yes.
Hey.
Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Trust in the Lord with all your might. Lean not to your own understanding this morning.
Yes, God.
In all your ways, acknowledge Him, and He will direct your path.
Yes, Lord.
God will give you wings
in
the time of your struggle. Hallelujah.
Yes,
glory be to God.
Glory.
There was a time in my life when I was going through so much. I'm saved, sanctified, Holy Ghost filled. But don't you know that we all go through our struggles?
Yes. Yes.
Glory be to God. Got nothing to do with you being saved. Glory be to God. If God puts you in a position and you have a destination, you better keep going, because if God is going to take you there, doesn't mean that it's going to be smooth the whole way through. Hallelujah. There is a point where you start and there is a point where you finish. But there is an in between. Glory be to God. What you will encounter in between might be uncomfortable.
Yes. Yes.
Glory be to God. But God will help you to go over all the hurdles.
Yes.
He will help you to move all the barriers.
Yes.
Hallelujah. When you fall, He will pick you up.
Yes.
Glory be to God. Hallelujah. When you feel like you're getting weary, He will say, I'll give you strength.
Yes.
For the scripture said, let the weak say, I am strong.
Yes.
Glory be to God. When you feel like you want to give up, glory be to God. God will whisper, keep moving on.
Uh-huh.
You see, there are some on the sidelines that bidding you to go on.
Mm-hmm.
Glory be to God, watching you while you continue this journey.
Yeah.
It's a race, it's not for the swift.
Mm-hmm.
This battle is not for the strong, but it's endurance that will take you.
Yes.
Can you stand the pruning? Glory be to God. So Sometimes God is pruning you. You all know what it is to be pruned. When you're doing a garden, hallelujah, you have to go out there and make sure that the weeds are separated from what you're growing. Glory be to God. Look at the roses with the thorns. Sometimes when you have to prune that rose, the thorns will stick you in your fingers. It's uncomfortable. But when God is pruning you, glory be to God. Hallelujah. Not all the time it's going to feel good, but know that he's pruning you for a purpose. Glory be to God. And sometimes the purpose that you have to go through the struggle in order to fulfill what God has for you. But he said, if you call on me, I will answer. Glory be to God. You must connect with the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. When you call on him, heaven hear you, for whatever you bind on earth is bound up already up in heaven. Whatever you loose on earth is loose in heaven. God is waiting for a prayer to activate whatever needs to be released from heaven. Glory be to God. Hallelujah, somebody. The reason why sometimes we struggle so much is because we're not in the position to touch the activation button. We don't pray like we used to pray before. We don't fast like we used to fast before. You see, prayer changes everything. And the way to communicate with God is through prayer, somebody. So if you activate it, glory be to God. God in his word will release it. Glory be to God. God will not show up unless you send him that invitation. Glory be to God. You see, God owns the authorization, but he gave us that authority to call him and he will come. Hallelujah, somebody. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. You see, Adam gave away the lease. Glory be to God. And so the devil is to and fro like a roaring lion, seeking whom he might devour. And he might just touch somebody in the wrong way, glory be to God. And you think that that's the only way you can remain, but you don't have to stay down when God says, arise and shine. You don't have to stay down if in the word he said, call me and I will answer you. You don't have to stay down because God said, in the time of trouble, I am there with you. You don't have to stay down because God said, I will lift you in the palm of my hand. I said this morning, I want to let you know you don't have to stay down. Just wait and see what God is going to do for you. Keep crying out to God and see what he's going to do for you. The scripture said, they that wait upon the Lord, they shall renew their strength. You see, sometimes we feel so weak, we want to give up. But this morning I want to tell somebody, you don't have to give up. Just wait and see what God is going to do. Call on him and he will answer. Let God do it for you this morning. And your strength will be renewed. Because he's the person that always renew our strength. Glory be to God. The scripture said we will mount up like wings of an eagle. Glory be to God. I started to look and research a little about the eagle and his wings. Hallelujah, somebody. And I read where the eagle lived. And after 30 years, the eagle will go to a place. Hallelujah. Because the feathers that the eagle have, glory be to God, and his strength is decreasing. At the age of 30, he will go to a hiding place. And he will pluck out all the feathers that remain. Hallelujah. And all the plaque. He will beat his beak on the rock. Glory be to God until it falls off. Glory be to God. But then he remained there until the feathers regrew again. Glory be to God. Hallelujah, somebody. He know that this beak can't do much anymore because the strength is decreased. But if you wait on the Lord, he will renew your strength. Glory be to God. The eagle have sense enough to know that when so. Hallelujah, somebody. So you see, the eagle is not an ordinary bird. Glory be to God. So know today that God is not an ordinary God. Hallelujah, somebody. Elijah said, you call on your God and let fire come. But the gods that they were calling on, the prophets of Baal, nothing could happen. But when Elijah called on the God of our salvation, glory be to God, fire came down from heaven. For God is not an ordinary God. He is a supernatural God. Hallelujah, he is the high being. Glory be to God, he is the gods of every God. Let every power be subjected to the higher power. Hallelujah, somebody. For there is only one God, eternally existing in three persons, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. There is only one Almighty God. There are many gods that we read about, but there is only one Almighty God. Hallelujah. So this morning I want to encourage somebody. God will give you wings in the time of your struggle. Hallelujah. The scripture says you will mount up like wings of an eagle. Walk and not be weary. Run and not faint. So God will give you the strength. There is strength in the Lord this morning.
Yes.
Let the weak say, I'm strong.
Mm-hmm.
There is strength. Knowing that God is the only one that can make a change in your life.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
He's the only one that can turn things around. He's the only one that will cause the enemy to be your footstool. Hallelujah. Whatever the enemy means for evil, God will turn it into good this morning. The struggles that you go through, sometimes you're very uncomfortable with it. But know that if you know God for yourself, that he's going to take you through.
Yes.
Wait on the Lord. Just wait. And God will help you in the time of trouble. For God will be your wings to go higher and higher and higher in him. There is a process to get there. The evil starts down and he keeps going. So God will take you there if you rest yourself in him. You see, you have to rest yourself in him.
Yes.
Somebody said, ride on the wings of love. God is love. So if you ride on the wings of God's love, he's going to take you there this morning. God bless you. May his light shine in you. May he give you strength this morning. Surely God is able to do what he says he will do. Fret not yourself this morning because of evildoers. Neither be thou envious against the workers of iniquity. Fret not yourself. God say, I go to prepare a place that where I am. He may be also. When Jesus died, he went down to heaven, snatched the key from the dead. Hallelujah. But today he's sitting at the right hand of God the Father, making intercession for us. The struggles that we go through, put it in the hands of God. For in the midst of your trouble, God will give you strength. God bless you.
Amen.
Hallelujah. We need a Savior.
Yes, Lord.
In times like these. Be very
Fly. Hey. 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 Come on, You've been too comfortable. You've been too comfortable. You said that. We've been too comfortable. And a lot of our problems and our issues. You know, sometimes when you're in problems, you start making a life out of your problems.
Yes.
Come on, glory. You try to adjust to your problem.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. But the Lord sent me the testimony, you getting free today.
Yeah.
Over there, I said it's something. I said it's something when you were standing up here mentioning them eagle wings. I said it's something how Isaiah had a fascination with wings because he described over there about the angels. The Bible says he saw seraphim above the throne of God, and they each had six wings.
Yes.
And the Bible says that with twain of the wings they covered their face.
Yes.
The twain to cover their feet,
yes.
And twain they flew.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Mm. And you know what I love about that? That all the six angels, the Bible says they cried one to another, crying, holy,
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 holy, holy,
holy,
holy, holy, holy.
Hallelujah. They cried, holy, Pastor. And I had a visual of what that looked like. There were six angels. Could you visualize six angels in a circle? And all they did was fly around in a circle. And together they cried holy. And the Bible says they cried to another. So they were looking at each other saying holy.
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 Hey.
Holy.
Woo.
I dare you to look at somebody right now and say holy.
Holy.
Holy. Holy. Holy. Holy. Say it like you believe it.
Holy.
You start saying holy. Some of your spirit starts striking.
Yes.
Tell you, there's too many people in jail still. They need to hear your voice. scream and say hallelujah to the top of your lungs.
Yes.
Jump up right now. 1, 2, 3. And I saw a young man in the spirit, and I saw an attack, hallelujah, in a car. Man shata bokoshia. I saw a car, hallelujah. I saw a car and I saw an attack for this young man. I saw the car get hit on the side, and then I saw bullets begin to come out of the car that hit it. And God told me to tell you, he said, again, I'm anointing you. Thank you, sir. God said, I'm anointing you, Kana Manshika, God said, I am anointing Hurry. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
He said, I'm covering you too. My Shika.
Hey.
God said, there'll be no ricochet to your house. God said, it will not backfire to your house. Hallelujah. And God told me to tell you he's covering you and protecting you right now.
Hey, hey.
Not joke on the glory.
Yes. Glory.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Glory.
Thank you.
Father, thank you for your protection.
Thank you.
Thank you for your protection.
Thank you.
And woman of God, the reason why I am praying with you strongly is because God says that the devil wants to take you off this new path that you're on. You're on a new path. You're on a new journey. God has put you in a new system. And God says, today I am protecting you. I am covering you. He said, I'm grounding you. God says, I'm grounding you.
Hallelujah.
And I heard the Lord say, he said, you shout this. You shout it real loud. And I want you to say to the top of your lungs, if you can, I want you to say, it's settled.
It's settled.
That was really good. I saw God giving you favor with the state of Arizona. I am my sheep. When I was sitting behind you today, no, don't give me the one that dropped. Give me the other one. All right? When I was sitting behind you today, God says he's giving you favor with the state. I'm going to tell you something. Now, I'm prophesying this money, but God said to you today, there's a special reason why you need this money. And I saw God says, he says, tell you I'm getting ready to change your health benefits. That's what God asked you.
Hallelujah.
God said, I'm going to change your health benefits, and I'm going to make them better. So that's why when I'm touching you right now, I'm not just touching you just to touch you. I shot you, and we agreed in the spirit. We shot you in a new place in the spirit realm. Your file has been brought to the top. There's a minister in you. There's a preacher in you. You come out and you'll see. The devil thought he had you, but you got away. Somebody lift your hand and thank God.
Glory! Hallelujah!
Hallelujah. Lift your hands. I'm going to tell you something. God told me to tell you, he said he's covering you too. Yep, and I'm going to tell you something. As I stand here now, Pastor, God is blessing that young man right now.
Come on now. Hey, yeah. Hey.
God. God is going to fill him. Hallelujah. God is going to fill you. Hallelujah. With the Holy Ghost.
Hallelujah.
Gonna give him the anointing of Gideon. God is giving him the anointing of Gideon, and even as I stand here, God is making a musician out of him. A guitar in this young man's hand, Pastor. He comes!
Glory!
I don't know if anybody heard what I said today. Hey, God is touching your life right now.
Glory.
Lift up your hand today, woman. I'm out here. Young lady, God is touching you right now. Here, come on. Can I pray for them?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Hallelujah.
I'm going to pray for you today.
Hallelujah.
Thank you. God is keeping his hand on you.
Thank you.
Hey.
Hey. Hey. Hey. Hey.
As I stood here, the reason why I asked for the keys, because I was getting ready to tell you that God's going to give you a new truck. I was just getting ready to ask for car keys, and the Lord stopped me and said they don't have a car yet. And God told me to tell you, young man, as I was standing here, God said he's going to give you a new employment.
Hallelujah.
They told me yesterday, they said my daughter, but they didn't catch it, and I said they should have called me. They didn't catch it. But God let some thieves put $5,000 in my daughter's account. Do you hear what I'm saying?
Oh, yes.
And they didn't get that $5,000 because they forgot to call me. And they called the bank and told the bank they made a mistake. And I told them, y'all didn't realize you've been sowing, you've been giving, you've been praying for money. God put the money in your account. Prophet, why are you telling us this? Why you mention your daughter? Because God says, daughter, he's going to put some money in your account.
Join hands.
hands real quick. Join hands. You just no, just these two. Join hands. Ikaraban shatanyaba. Let me grab your hand real quick. Ikarandiasi. God, apostle, pastor, y'all grab each other's hands real quick. God is transporting all three groups somewhere right now. Father, thank you right now.
Thank you. Thank you, Jesus.
We go where you send us.
Yes.
Yes. Lord, we go where you send us.
Thank you, Lord.
Yes. Thank you, Lord. Isha. Pastor, apostle, men and women of God, I'm glad you stood right there because I was just going to call you. The Lord said the reason why I told y'all to hold hands and I took to the agreement with you all, because right now I saw y'all traveling and I saw you driving a van. I saw you driving the van. Now, let me tell you something. Thank you, Father. I just heard it, Lord. Thank you, Father. As I stand here now, I want you to check your driving record. Okay? Check it, because the Holy Spirit says He's protecting you and your driving record. Hallelujah. Just stand here now.
Glory!
God is protecting your driving record right now.
Hallelujah.
So just check the DMV just to make sure. Alright? God's gonna do a miracle for you. God's gonna do a miracle for you. Alright? Now, there's some finances and some money you need. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
God's a Mashiach. God's sending you some money and some finances.
Hallelujah.
It's coming to you right now.
Lord,
Rabbi Shaya.
Yes,
Mother, shake your right leg. Shake it again.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Go grab your purse. Go grab your purse and shake it.
Hallelujah.
I want you to hear the change coming in your purse. Right? Woman of God, I told you to shake your right leg. I told you to shake your right leg because God said I'm going to help you stand. Hallelujah. And when I was sitting over there, apostle, pastor, but I was sitting over there. The Lord told me to tell you, he said, this is the bodyguard right here.
Yeah.
I want both of y'all to say right now, say perfect security.
Perfect security.
Glory.
Hallelujah.
Thank you.
You are secure. God is blessing you right now. God is blessing you right now. And glory.
Hallelujah. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
When you handed me water, you handed me water twice today. And the Lord said, you passed the test. God said to me in my ear, Pastor, Apostle, God said to me, he said, you passed the test. Hallelujah. God said, he said, it was an act of humility when you gave me the water. It wasn't just you hang out water to guests. God said it was an act of humility. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
God said you passed the test. And the Lord said he's giving you, God, I heard the Lord say elevation right now. God's elevating you right now. And God says he's giving you an assignment to protect this man. To protect this man and protect this woman of God. This man of God. This woman of God. He's giving you, Lord says, elevate you right now. Hallelujah.
Yes, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Hallelujah.
Thank you.
Yes, Father. Thank you, God. Hallelujah. God sent me here especially to pray for you today. I cannot leave until I pray for you.
Thank you.
As I lay my hand on your chest right now, I heard the Lord say he's protecting your lungs.
Thank you.
I saw God say to me, he says, tell you, you won't need surgery. There's no surgery. God said he's protecting you and there'll be no surgery. I saw the hand of a doctor getting ready to cut in your chest, and I saw a scar left in your chest in the spirit realm. And God stopped it today. Yes, God. Now, I'm going to tell you something. God says, tell you today he's giving you a brand new start.
Yes.
God said, this is a new beginning for you right now.
Yes.
God says, I'm trusting you with the new beginning.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah. And I saw God put in a rainbow. It's something, I'm seeing this in the spirit, but at the same time, I'm seeing it literally. And I'm seeing a rainbow over your head.
Yes.
I'm seeing a rainbow over you. Now, I'm seeing in the spirit further. I'm seeing a few days from now. I'm seeing you sit, and there's a wall behind you. And as there's a wall behind you, I see a rainbow over your head, and I see some clouds.
Yes.
Glory to God. And I want to say, it's like when you go to the nursery schools, or you go to the kindergarten, or the preschool, the pre-Ks. And you go to their classrooms, and they have those pictures on the walls. But I see you in those rooms, and I see a rainbow right behind your head, and I see some clouds, little clouds, hallelujah, over your head. Glory to God, while you're sitting down and standing up, hallelujah. And the Lord says, tell you it's a sign. He's giving you a new start. And I'm going to tell you something.
Ooh.
Something's going to happen in your favor, in your favor. And God somehow is going to have you in a school teaching little kids or watching them or something like that. That's what I see. Glory to God. But I see him sitting there, and I see them doing a little lesson, not too much, but I see them doing lesson. I see you teaching them. I see you sit down. I see you teaching them. I see them drawing. Yes, Father. I see them drawing. I see red crayons and red construction paper. Hallelujah. On the table, the little table. Glory to God. And I see different multicolored chairs. Yes, Father. Yes, Lord. And I'm telling you right now, God is trusting you with a new assignment. God's trusting you with a new assignment.
Hallelujah.
Yes, God. Give me the shout. Because the Lord said he's changing and expunging some things off your record right now. Setting her record free, the enemy is going to try to come and tie you up. But that's why God warned you. See, God loves us and so wise that he warns us ahead of time. The beauty about God giving us men and women of God is that we have eyes to see ahead of time. We already know what's coming.
Hallelujah.
We already see it ahead of time. Because God has already showed it to us.
Hallelujah.
So it's no strange thing. We say, oh, we knew that. God, he told us it was happening already.
Hallelujah.
We know what to look out for.
Yes, sir.
Because God is warning us.
Yes.
He's showing us ahead of time of what's to come.
Yes.
Of the dangers and the traps of the enemy.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Glory
yes.
to God.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God. Hallelujah. Apostle, even God's got some other angels. The Bible said they have eyes throughout the whole entire body. Got eyes throughout the whole body.
Yes.
On the front of them and the back of them.
Yes.
They got eyes throughout the whole body. He shut up on so nothing gets away from them.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. God, Ikaya is giving you this warning. Because God's blessing you. Come here, woman of God. I had a vision today, and even the other day, but this morning specifically, I had this vision, and I had, stand right here, son. And I had this vision, Apostle, can you come here real quick? I had this vision today, and when I had a vision, the vision I had was, God said to lay our hands on this woman. And the Lord says, as we were praying with her today, as we were praying for her and praying with her today, hallelujah, God says that he was doing something in you. And he was raising you up. Yes. And he was protecting you. Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
I saw you in the spirit, and as I looked in the spirit, I saw you praying for some people. And behind you was a white building. It was a white building. And then I saw it was a white building. And I saw you go in this building, and the roof of the building looked like an A shape. Tell ya, looked like an A shape, came down like an A shape. And you went in the building, and you were praying for some people. And before you went in, I saw some white sand under your feet. Hallelujah. And the Lord says, "Tell you," he says, "I'm taking you to new ground, new territory." And the Lord said, "You're going to be my prayer intercessor and my prayer warrior." Hallelujah. Apostle, God told me to say over this room, he says, your prayers are being answered and heard right now. Father, I thank you now.
Thank you.
I give you praise for this woman. Healing is hers today. Life is hers today. Yes, God.
Yes, Lord.
You are raising this woman up.
Yes, Lord Jesus.
she will pray for your people.
Yes,
God. She will sing and pray for your people. God, and I bless you now. Father, even this house shall be full of her prayers.
Hallelujah.
This very house we're in right now.
Hallelujah. Yes, Lord.
I thank you now.
Hallelujah.
Apostle, the Lord said, this woman is praying for you when you sleep.
Yes, Lord.
God said, she's praying for you. He called my mother. And I heard the Lord say, she's been praying that God take away the wrong people from around you and put the right people around you.
Yes. Glory. Hallelujah.
Yes, Father. He's shy. Hey. Lord said, this woman has got your back and your throat. Lord told me to tell you, Apostle, God, Pastor, you too, God said, this woman loves you very much. God said, not many people have true love for you, but God says to tell you, Apostle, this woman loves you very much. And woman of God, the Lord said, because you stuck it out, and because you stayed, God said, I'm giving you a great favor.
Thank you.
Over the next 31 days, God is going to do great miracles for you. Yes, Father. God says, tell you it's going to rain. I heard the Lord say it's going to rain. God said, rain!
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 Glory to God. Hallelujah.
It come out.
Hallelujah.
I want you, after this service is over, I want you to go get a pink, I'm sorry, yes, thank you, Father, a pink and a purple pen. Yes, Father. And I want you to write down rain. Yes, God. Yes, Father. I want you to write down rain on a blank sheet of paper. And I want you to stick it in your Bible. Yes, Father. Yes, God. Thank you, Father. And I hear the Lord says, tell you, you're about to reap a harvest. Yes, God. And just whisper something to God right now, everybody. Yay. Whisper something to the Lord.
Yes.
It could be anything. Just whisper. Everybody whisper something to God. God, you're blessing this woman and we see it and we thank you. You're blessing this lady and I thank you right now. Apostle, put your hands on the stomach. I'm going to put my hand on top of yours.
Thank you.
God said, I got you covered. I got you covered. He said, I'm putting it in your belly right now. Yes, Father. It's already yours. Yes. It's already yours right now. Get ready for the miracles. Go grab Pastor's hand real quick. Hurry up and go grab his hand. Shake his hand and say hallelujah. Watch what happens.
Thank you.
Hallelujah.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I want you to, y'all make sure you remember the name Lawrence. Remember the name Lawrence. Remember the name Lawrence. Lawrence. Hiya Babasha. Great favors coming to you right now. Great favors coming. And the Lord says, tell you, he's going to give you access to a brand new studio.
Hallelujah.
Glory. A new studio's coming to this young man, Pastor.
Hallelujah.
A new studio's coming.
Glory.
Hallelujah.
Glory.
Hallelujah. Can y'all do me one more favor? Can y'all stand up real quick? And I'm done after this. Hallelujah. I want y'all to lift your hands in the air right now. Lift your hands high. Lord, I'm going to pray this, and y'all just agree with me. Father, I thank you for this man.
Thank you, Jesus.
You touched him, and you blessed him, and you healed him.
Yes, Lord. Yes.
Father,
oh, yes, Lord.
Even your feet.
Yes,
man, God lost it. Even your feet are being blessed in the Lord.
Yes, Lord.
You're going to start feeling. Lord said, you're going to feel fire in your feet. You're going to start feeling fire in your feet.
Yes,
Lord. I'm telling you, sir, God is going to do some great things in your life.
Yes.
As the scripture says, I want you to, thank you, Father. I want you to read it every day.
Hallelujah.
Where the scripture says, I have not seen.
Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. I want you to write down three numbers, Apostle, three numbers. I want you to write down 7,
mm-hmm.
17, and 700. 7, 17, and 700. The Lord said these numbers will be significant to you. They'll be significant to you. And the Lord is going to do some miracles in your life. I see you walking through a new door right now. I see you walking through a new door right now. And as this one particular door, as I see you walking through, I see you walking through a door, and I see a table on the right side and a mirror on the wall. Yes. Mirror, mirror on the wall. Tell me who you are. You are the woman of God.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Glory.
You are
the vessel of God. Yeah, God.
Glory to God.
You are the servant of God.
Yeah.
Message that you preach today.
Thank you, Jesus.
May God give you over $1,000 for this message.
Thank you, Jesus.
That you minister today.
Yes.
And God is going to bless you. The great faith is coming to you.
Yes.
God says you've been specially designed by Him.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Specially designed by God.
Yes.
Custom made.
Yes, Lord.
I was listening to you today, and the Lord spoke in my right ear. And the Lord says, the reason why He gave you an accent, not just because of where you're from, but God said He gave you an accent because He made you different. God said your accent is the thing that will stand out when you stand to minister. God said, in the mind of God, God took me all the way to the day that you were created. And God told me, He said, I was sitting there He said to me, son, I was sitting today. God said he was sitting on the throne, and when he came to you, making you, he said, I know how I'll make her different. I'll put an accent in her.
Wow.
Hey. I was sitting there, and God said, he said in my right ear, he said, son, if I would have made her without the accent, she wouldn't have stood out. She just would have been another regular person, another regular preacher. He said, but the accent is a thing that makes me remember that she is alive.
Hey,
hey. I'm telling you, woman of God, this anointing in your life is powerful. God's not through with you yet. I want you to go get some grapes before you get home, or somebody give us some grapes. And the Lord said, I want you to put them in a basket. You could eat the grapes. And God said, this will be a sign to you that I'm sending you to a new land. And in the new land is new grapes.
Like a week ago, my faith was really being tested. doing nothing to help me. And then, you know, I realized what I did. I started apologizing, crying out to him. I'm sorry, please forgive me for what I said. And, you know, I had just enough money to pay off an eviction from my apartment. I got evicted from my just enough money. And then some doors opened up for me to get my license back, and my license was suspended for 2 years.
Amen.
But I only had enough money for one or the other. Amen. You know, my license came up first, and I said, God, if it's not meant for me to get my license right now, please just show me. If it's time for the apartment right now, I got my license, just give me that sign.
Wow.
And the courts had told me when I paid it, they said, MVD is going to automatically suspend your license for another 3 months because you didn't have insurance. But when I got there, they said, we're not going to suspend you for 3 months.
No,
I
know.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
God, you're gonna make this apartment thing still happen. And the next day, I got my apartment paid off.
Wow.
Yeah. Amen.
And I feel like my faith has really been strengthened.
Like after
that, like I really feel like he's listening to me now. It feels good.
Amen.
And I just wanted to say that.
Yeah. Praise God. Amen. And we're praising God with you because that's why the Lord gave you your truck.
Ah.
Automatically approved for our apartment. And he said we would have to pay more than first month's rent because of his credit, but we only have to pay first month's.
Thank you.
I found out that because we've been, like you said, we've been tested through the week with this apartment. They've been sending us, making us jump through hoops to bring all these documents, and I had got upset with God. And I told him, I was like, Lord, I gave my seat. I sold my seat too. He said to him, I gave to my offering. I gave my tithe. I'm blessed enough to write because you know we need a blessing. And I'm not asking for money, Lord. I just need you. You see my car. I have no air. My babies can't drive in this. My apartment, you know, or my family needs this apartment. And I felt like God was trying to, tell us, I don't know exactly how to explain it, but I felt like God wasn't going to bless us. Like, he was trying to show us, see, this could happen, but because you're not being faithful with me, I'm not going to let it happen. So I was asking, why, Lord, you see my heart. You see I'm trying to do this for you. You see I need this blessing from you. And then after I said all that, I felt like what I said to God, he wasn't going to bless us at all. And then you came today and told me that. And I just thank God for it.
Thank you, Father.
Hallelujah.
Hey,
hallelujah.
Hey, to the
amen.
Sorry, D. The other day, God just gave me songs. Amen.
Yeah.
The other day, I was singing a song that God had gave me. And for some reason. No, I wasn't going to sing it. I wasn't going to sing it. I'm just telling them. But for some reason, God been putting in my spirit, holy, 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 holy. And it added to the song, holy. My wife started crying. And it was holy, holy, holy.
Wow.
When he came today, he was saying,
holy.
God wants to be holy, holy, holy. And I was like, amen. So I just wanted to
praise God.
That ain't nothing but God.
Praise
amen.
God.
Everything.
Praise God.
Prophet McKinney.
Yes, ma'am.
When you lift that baby.
Yes, ma'am.
I told Jasmine before she gave birth to him, I said, God called me to be a prophet.
Wow.
In the end times, he's going to raise him up.
Wow.
And today you came and told me that he's a prophet and he lifted up.
Wow.
Amen. Anybody else?
God not willing that it is.
Come on.
Praise God.
I
want to
say something.
Come on, mother.
I just want to thank God for the way he does things. And sometimes when God is doing some things, if we don't pay attention, we lose the whole thing. I thank God for the prophet paying attention.
Yes.
And listening to what God is saying. You know, I am truly blessed by the word that you gave me today. Almost all the members in the ministry know my story, my testimony, how the doctor sent my mother home for her to miscarry me. And it took almost 10 months before she had me, a couple days before 10 months. But they had sent her home because I was across in her womb and wouldn't move. So they just sent her home, told her to wait for the miscarriage and come back. And so her friend took her to a prayerful, praying mother. And as soon as she came through the gates, the lady told her, stop. I don't want you coming in here because you're going to die. And I don't want you dying. My mother went home, and the same night, and I tell that testimony everywhere I go, the same night, two people came to my mother in a vision. One looked like her mother, one looked like her grandmother. And they took some blessed oil, and they started to rock her stomach just before midnight. Rock their stomach. And the long story short is, before daybreak, she was in labor pain. Her water broke. They took her to the hospital, and I was born.
Wow.
And I didn't understand the story until I got saved. Then the Lord told me, I wouldn't let you come before I anointed you.
Wow.
Listening to what God,
hallelujah.
When God is talking, if we just listen, but I thank you for the word today, because I did preach one day and I told them, God said that my accent is not an accident.
You cut my mouth.
Oh, I preached it at the Bishop Church in Coolidge.
Wow.
My accent is not an accident.
Not an accident.
So I know God is talking.
Woo!
And God continues to bless you.
Wow.
And you do what God is doing with you. Continue in the word. God
praise
bless
God.
You, son.
I just want to say this. I just give God thanks. Amen. I've always, from the moment that I met Prophet Meekins, I've always believed that he was a true prophet. Never had doubt about that. But I just want you to know that the part that you talked about, love,
yes.
God knew that I was struggling
wow.
loving my husband.
Yes.
And he's rekindling our marriage.
Yes, yes.
Because we were, a couple months ago, we were on
yes,
the verge of
yes,
a divorce.
Yes, yes, yes.
But God brought us back together, and it was hard for me to fuck my husband
yes.
because something that we were going through. But since he brought us back together and restored things,
yes.
I asked God, Lord, don't let me stop loving you.
Yeah. Wow.
Don't let me stop. But let me love you more than I ever have before. And don't ever let me stop loving you. So what you said to me, that was confirmation for me. And I just thank God for that.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. Thank you. Praise God Almighty. The old song says, praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise him above ye heaven. Wasn't it praise from God?
Yeah.
So is anybody hungry? We have lunch. But I'm telling you what, I'm full now. I'm full.
Yes, sir.
Right,
yes,
right
sir.
Now.
Hey, glory. Yes, sir.
Well, listen, I'm going to let them.
Woo! Just yesterday, I believe it was yesterday, Kevin and I were, no, the night before, because he was massaging my feet. And I told him, I said, Kevin, we need a studio.
Wow.
We need to get a studio for you.
Wow.
We need God to work the studio out.
Yes.
Because I know that God has great things for this young man.
Yes,
mm-hmm.
yes.
God has great things of profit. If you need him,
yes.
just let me know.
Yes, ma'am.
I'll send him your way.
Wow. Praise God.
As long as never on a Sunday.
Yes, yes, never.
Because he's right here.
That's right. I know that's right. Hey, look, y'all can't have this one either.
Amen. Yeah, well.
Look, one day we'll just trade them. We'll trade one. Amen. Look, and we trade, you send mine, and I send yours.
Amen.
Praise God.
Thank you, Lord. Aye, aye, aye.
Thank you.
Yes, Lord. Yes.
Let Deacon do what he's supposed to do, and then we'll come on, Deacon.
Amen. Certainly, we just thank God for the messenger and the messenger. Amen. give it to them out of their heart, that it be put on them. And we know that the tithe is already his, so we don't have to think about the tithe. And then the Bible doesn't say your blessing come from your offering.
Yes, yes.
Amen.
So whatever you give, amen, give it unto the Lord.
Yes.
So we're not going to stand in line. Amen. If you believe the envelope, raise your hand while I'm talking. Amen. So it's time, amen, for us to just bring our offering. See, a lot of times we go, people go around and receive offering. But the Bible says, bring your offering to the storehouse.
Yeah,
so we just want to let you bring your offering.
Yes, yes.
Give it back to you. Give and give it back to you. Give and give it back to you. Press down, shaking together. Running over in good measure. Yes, I'm coming back to you. Give and I give it back to you. Give and I give it back to you. Give and I give it back to you. Press down, shaking together.
Yes.
That's it?
All right, amen. That's it.
Lord, every morning.
Praise Hallelujah.
The Lord. Praise the Lord, every morning.
Hallelujah.
Praise God. We thank God for just showing up today.
Amen.
You know, it wouldn't work the trip if God wasn't here.
Amen.
If God didn't show up, then it would just be coming into the house and having a good time and leaving. Mm-hmm. But we were truly blessed today. And we thank God that it's not about the good feeling preaching, it's about when God show up.
Amen.
Praise God. I thank God for the prophet in the house.
Amen.
Today, praise the Lord, as I stood here preaching, I heard the Spirit of God told me, now you say what I tell you to say and give the prophet some way. Praise the Lord. And I was obedient. They'll tell you usually I'm preaching longer, but I heard what the Holy Ghost said.
Amen.
And it's good to be obedient to the Holy Ghost, because God just show up and did what he had to do today.
Yes.
Praise God. So we thank God. We're going to all stand. We're going to close out. Praise God. We thank God for the minister that is with the prophet today. Praise the Lord. Thank God. Father, we just thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, God. Thank you for showing up today. Thank you for blessing us. Oh God, as we depart from this place, but not from your presence, we pray that you cover us with the blood of Jesus. Build a fence and a shield of protection around us. Guide us from every harm, every danger, every evil. In the name of Jesus today, God, counteract every plan of the enemy. Fly every trap and every snare of God in the name of Jesus. Cancel every plan in the name of Jesus. Oh God, you arise and let the enemies be scattered. And God, we thank you, God, for your word today. Thank you, God, for the prophet today. Thank you, God, for showing up, God. Oh God, and blessing us in this service. God, we give you the praise and we give you the glory and the honor. Bless our pastor and the apostle, Lord. Continue, Lord Jesus, to give pastor his speedy recovery. By your stripe, he is healed.
Hallelujah.
And God, we just stand by and watching the healing. God, strengthen the apostle, God, as she continued, God, to take care of the man of God. Lord, bless each and every one individually, Lord, today and collectively. Lord, we give you praise. Bless the food that we're about to eat. Sanctify God. Oh God, purge it out, God, in the name of Jesus. Oh God, and we thank you and we praise you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Give somebody a hug and tell them you love them. Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Well, welcome back. I'm glad you tuned in today just to listen to what thus saith the Lord. I'm so grateful that God has given us opportunity. You know, there were a lot of people who decided last night when they laid down that they were going to get up this morning and get to the house of God, but it didn't happen. And so for those of you who were able to tune in today, for those that were in service today, you know that you were blessed by the Lord to be able to hear his word and to participate in his praise and worship. And so I want to say until next week, God keep you and God bless you. I just want to remind you that we are still in a building fund drive. So you can go to GoFundMe.com and look for Jesus Ministries Bread of Life. Whatever the Lord lays on your heart to donate to us, please do. We are not greedy, and there is no gift that is too small. So if you find it in your heart to do that, please do that. And so until next Sunday, this is Pastor Wilson from Jesus Ministries Bread of Life. We are signing off, and hopefully you'll have a blessed week in the Lord, and we'll see you next Sunday.